That's my custom thumbnail. It's mine. No one else has it, so it is custom. Want to create custom thumbnails for all your YouTube videos so that they're more engaging and people notice them? And guess what else happens? You get more views? You know I got your back, baby. Let's get into it. Alright peeps, let's get our custom thumbnail on. I'm going to show you how to create a custom thumbnail for free. I know you like the word free, right? In order to do that, I'm going to show you a few of the sites that I went to grab some things that will help you get this done free of charge. One thing you always want for your thumbnails is a beautiful font. There are a lot of different places out there on the net that you can get fonts for free. One of those places, one of the best places in my opinion, is thefont.com. I say that because it has a lot of quality fonts out there, a lot of different choices. It's just a good site. So here at the beginning or the top of the page, you have a section here, and there's a lot of different categories that you can click on. You can choose from a bunch of different categories, whatever you like. I'm going to go to old school. Once you click on a category, you can scroll down the page and you'll find several different fonts within that category that you can use. Now, I kind of like this Friday Night Light one here, so I'm going to roll with this. Over to the right of the font, you'll see a download button. Also, you can donate to the author if you wish to do so. It's not mandatory, but it is nice. These people put in some work to create some of these fonts. So if you got a few dollars or something, donate to them, all right? Now, when you click on the download button, wherever your downloads pop up, you'll see that it is downloading on Chrome. I have it down here on the bottom left-hand side of the screen, and it's putting in work trying to download the font right now. Now, when the font is done downloading, you can either click on the file to open up the zip file, or you can click on this arrow here, say show in folder, and then you can click on the zip file, and then you have some files here in front of you. Now, the file you want to focus on if you're using a Windows computer is the .ttf. This is a true type font file. If you double click on this, it opens up a page that allows you to install the font on your system. Once it is on your system, you can use it with any program that can access the fonts on your computer. So if I click on install, it's going to install the font onto my computer, and now I can access it in Photoshop, paint.net, Word, whatever. So I'm going to go ahead and close this out. And now I want to show you another site. freedigitalphotos.net. Now, you need to have a good background for your thumbnail. This is a place where you can get a lot of free backgrounds that you can utilize royalty free without having to pay a red cent. Now, if you click on one of these backgrounds, you can search whatever you want to. And when you click on one of them, it gives you the license. Now, the standard license, it tells you, if I were to click on this little icon here, it tells me that with the standard license, it's free. The file size is small. Okay, so keep that in mind. I can use this anywhere I want to, as many times as I want to, as long as I want to, for any illustration, almost any business, personal, anything like that. Now, if you do it for free, then you need to give a published acknowledgement to freedigitalphotos.net and the creator of the image where it's used. So that means that if you want to use one of these for the background of your video, then what I would do is in the description, I would go ahead and acknowledge freedigitalphotos.net and the individual who made it, who is GUBGIB. I would acknowledge both of them in the description of my video to make sure that I was abiding by the rules of freedigitalphotos.net. All right. All you got to do is click on download. You'll download it. Select the location. I'm not going to do all of that right now. Last freebie is a photo editor. paint.net. So this is getpaint.net. When you go to getpaint.net, you get to download this free photo editor, which is probably really close to the closest you're going to get to Photoshop for something that's free. All right. So this is where you download it. It's a little link right here. You download it, put it on your computer. What I would also recommend is that you grab yourself some of the free plugins for this program because they make life very easy for you. So I'm going to find these plugins by just doing a search for paint.net plugins. And I'm going to click on this one here that says Megalo Effects and File Types. And in here you have a lot of plugins for getpaint.net. I have this one, which is the Megalo Effects plugin pack and the Attila Pro pack version 1. So you can just click on download installer and it'll go ahead and walk you through the install process so that when you open up getpaint.net, these are available under the effects section. All right, I'm done talking about where to get free stuff. Let's make a frickin' thumbnail already. Let's close this up. So you see I have paint.net here. I'm going to open this up. Now the first thing I want to do is change the size of the canvas because the best size for a thumbnail on YouTube is 1280 by 720. So I'm going to go to Image, Canvas Size. I'm going to change the width to 1280 and the height to 720. And then I'm going to click on OK. Now I can click on View and zoom out on here a little bit just to make it easier for me to see. The next thing we need to do is add our background to the canvas. So I'm going to go to Layers, Import from File, and I'm going to navigate to the folder where the image I want to use as the background is, and here it is. And now I'm going to click on Open. Now, this image is a lot larger than the 1280 by 720, which is why I took up the whole screen and more. So if you have a similar issue, the image is too small, it's too big, all you need to do is go to Image, Resize, and you can do 1280 by 720 so it matches, and then click on OK. And now it's the same size as the background layer that's underneath it. Next thing I want to do is add a little bit of blur to this because I want it to be some separation between the letters and objects or pictures that I add to the background. So if I go to Effects and go down to Blurs, there's a whole bunch of different blurs on here, and these are from the effects that I talked about, the plugins that you can add. So I'm going to add a Gaussian Blur. And I'm going to turn the radius up a little bit, and you can see the preview of how it's affecting the image right as you do it, which is pretty cool. That's pretty good there. So I'm going to click on OK. And that's a wrap. So the next thing I want to do is add some text. So I'm going to go to Layer and Add New Layer. Now I'm going to go to my Text Tool And I'm going to select the font. I'm gonna roll with the Crack Man. I'm gonna click on Crack Man. And then I can select the font size that I want. And I want the text to be on the top and the bottom, so I'm gonna hit enter a few times, bring this down some. And now there's a little plus sign down here. If I click on that with my left mouse and drag it, I can move this over to where I want. So I like that there. There's a few other things I want to do to this. So I want to go to effects. And I'm going to go down to object. And I want to put a drop shadow on this. And you can automatically see the drop shadow was applied, but I want a black shadow. Black shadows are real. Red shadows aren't. I want to make my offset on here how I like. And I think that's pretty good. It helps it stand out even more because of the shadow on there. So I like that. I like how that's looking so far. So I'm going to click on OK. So now we got the basis of our little thumbnail. But one thing I always want to add to thumbnails if I can is a face or a picture. The reason why is because for some reason people gravitate towards faces. I guess they're nosy or they want to see what somebody looks like or whatever. But people gravitate towards faces. So if there is a reason to add a face, add a face. It could be the whole background. It could be a picture with people in it doing something. Whatever you want. But you gotta have a face in it if it makes sense. If it doesn't, keep the face out. So what I'm gonna do now is go to Layers. Import from File. And I'm gonna find a location where I have a crackhead face. And that's pretty crackish. Okay, once again, this bad boy's kind of big, so I'm gonna bring him down to size here. If you notice, everything jumped over to the side and stuff because I added that big head of mine in there. So I'm just gonna go to Image, go back to Canvas Size, and make sure it's still 1280. By 720, hit enter or OK, and it should bring everything back center where it's supposed to be. So I'm going to click on this head guy here, and I'm going to try to bring him back down to size so he fits. Now, if you need to resize it and you want to keep the same aspect ratio, just hit your shift key and then left click, and it doesn't matter what I do now, I'm going straight down, but it's keeping the aspect ratio. So that's a good way to make sure you don't mess up the aspect ratio of your pictures. So I got this bad boy right where I want him. Crackhead Chronicles, starring your boy. I don't know why I got myself on there as a crackhead, but anyway. So now because there's some shadows on this, I want to add some shadow to this guy too. So I'm going to go to Effects. Go to Object. Drop Shadow. And it's basically just about the same as the other one already. So I'm just going to click on OK. And then also, he's got a little green around him. It's a little green screenshot. So I'm going to go to Effects. Object. And Outline Object. And just want to see if I can get rid of that green. I got rid of some of it, but he still got some on him. I like it a little bit better like that than it was before. And so now, all you got to do is save your thumbnail. So you can go to File, Save As, give it whatever name you want. You want to click on this little arrow next to Save As Type. And you want to make it a JPEG for your custom thumbnail on YouTube. Choose a location where you want to save it at and click on Save. So it's telling you configuration, default, all that. It gives you a good little preview of it. I'm cool with that. I'm going to click on OK. It's asking me if I want to flatten it out because it's made of different layers, or it's going to tell me you need to flatten it to make it a JPEG. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Flatten. Should be good to go. If I go to Location, you got your finished product.
All right, guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments, you know I love comments. Leave me questions, I'll give you answers. All right, you need help, you're in the right place. Don't forget, subscribe. Click on the little button to the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on. And if you need some more YouTube love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. You guys know what to do, so get to clicking.